welcome to the program, Roxanne.
Thank you so much,
Tiki Boy.
Wow.
Is this a new look?
This is just a regular look. It's a regular 3 hour to be here look.
Ah, talaga?
Took me 3 hours. No, including the makeover. It's, you know, it's such a blessing to be on your show and I want to prepare, but...
No, wait. You know, it's almost a no makeup thing.
I kept myself away from the eyelash extensions.
No, except
to
for
keep
that,
a natural
you know?
Look. Sinabi ko talaga lang.
But this one is really natural
no
and it's nice. No, really.
Thank you, Tito Boy. Dito.
This one, yes. But it looks good, really.
And I really wanted to do the whole Nadine, you know, drunk blush. But for a change, there's no blush today.
Oh.
Bogey Diaz style. I got you, girl. I get it.
Okay.
Di niya binigay.
Sa TNT, ang yung, how do you call that? Your title, your sobriquet.
The Wednesday group winner.
Diba? The Wednesday group, the contra diva ng Makati.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Do you like that, the contra diva ng Makati?
I think it's the wittiest, nice. Wittiest na title that they gave me. Na,
okay.
Nakakaya naman Tito Boy to correct sexy contra diva.
I wanted to get it right. Sexy contra diva ng Makati.
Baka kasi, diba? Wala lang. Nahiya tuloy ako. I'm blushing.
No, but you know, I think I caught you during your episode sa TNT. Was it Dulce who said, Dulce bang nagsabing come back to singing?
Miss Dulce and Miss Shasha were very encouraging.
Yeah, I saw that. Na parang, you know, people have to be reminded that you are actually a singer, that you started as a singer.
Tito Boy, including myself.
Talaga?
Binabaon ko talaga siya.
Bakit?
In the back of
Bakit?
My head. It comes with a lot of, wow! Woo, Tito Boy, I can't lie to you. Wait lang.
Yeah.
There's so much feelings going on.
That's okay.
It comes with a lot of trauma.
Oh.
Singing itself. When I was 18, I was parang gifted a album recording deal with Universal Records. And I had no idea that the owner of it, Belyatan, Miss Belyatan, she had cancer that metastasized.
Okay.
And that was probably her last project. And she didn't tell me or I had no idea, but I treated her like my second mom. She treated me like a daughter. And I had the best time of my life recording
Friend
and making
mine.
Music.
Friend of mine. I mean, I know
Belia,
of course.
Belia, yes. Of course. So, dinala siya ni Kuya Germs back in the day to my debut. And hindi ko alam na siya ang surprise guest ni Kuya Germs. Biglang, pak! I know her because nakikita ko siya sa TV, sa ASAP, napapanood ko
Naga-award.
Siya. Naga-award. Naga-award for the multi. Gold, platinum, keme. Okay. Sabi ko, suddenly she's here. Parang, kala ko nanonood lang ako ng TV. But lo and behold, she was at my birthday giving the 18th treasure.
Which was
not only a necklace. Nagbigay siya ng necklace, but she also gave me the gift of a recording deal in front of all, lahat-lahat na kamag-anak ko mula sa Laguna, Bulacan, Bacood, Santa Mesa, lahat sila. Woo! Talagang they were all so happy for me. Tas,
all right.
Ano, I was,
so
it
take
was
me
a
to
gift.
Take me to the trauma. How did it become a trauma?
She passed away.
Oh,
after
she did?
After namin ma-release ang album, nag-number one ang Kung Alam Mo Lang, na hindi alam ng mga tao na si Roxy is Roxanne Barcelo. Pero yun kasing nickname na tawag niya sa akin. Sabi niya, I want everyone na kung ano yung tawag ko sa'yo, yun yung maging tawag ng lahat. So Roxy talaga.
So sumikat yung kanta and you felt na kilala nila si Roxy bilang singer nung awitin, pero hindi nila alam na si Roxy ay si Roxanne.
Yes. Uh-huh. Tapos ano lang siya, sabi niya magbabakasyon lang daw siya papunta sa States. Tapos nung pagbalik na niya, Gary V, all her artists, Gary V, parokya ni Edgar, ako, dumalaw kami sa kanya, but ako, I went separately, and nung nakita ko siya, sabi ko, oh wow, like, ang bilis ng
Panahon.
Panahon. What happened?
Okay.
And when she passed that week, I saw her 3 days before she passed away.
Okay.
After that, I said, I will never sing again. Because she's the only one who believed in me at that time. Apart okay. from my parents, of course.
Okay. So that's how traumatic it is.
Yeah.
I mean, singing, music.
5 years, sabi ko hindi ako kumanta. And then, in
kailan
church...
Kailan ka nagbalik?
Sa church, nangangailangan sila lagi ng makeup artist. So behind the scenes, minimakeupan ko yung mga praise and worship leader.
Okay.
I do their kilay, eyeshadow and everything. Uh-huh. And then sabi nila, we need a backup singer. Dead ma ako. I die. I hide. Biglang, Roxanne, can you do backup for us? Sabi okay. ko, ha? Huh? Madami pang iba dyan. Alam naman nila yung kanta. Hindi kailangan mo mag-backup. Tapos wala naman silang alam na umiiwas talaga ako.
Okay.
And then, when I started singing for church, when I started singing for the Lord, nag-iba yung ihip ng hangin.
Tuloy-tuloy na?
Hindi pa rin. Naman full force. Paunti-unti for the Lord. And then, on Sundays, ganyan. Tapos, iba din talaga yung fears that come with it. And then, I wrote a few songs like Morena with other co-writers of mine. I wrote another set of songs, pero ang gusto lang makinig is my tatay. When I drive for him, sasabihin niya, anak, play mo nga yung sinulat mong kanta. Mga 2 years ago, I wrote a few songs with this guy named Amir. And, siya lang. Only my dad listens to the songs. And it's stored in my laptop. And then, recently, mga May 30, he texted. Tatay ko, sabi niya, sayang ang mga kanta mo, anak. Ilabas mo na ang mga kanta mo with Amir. Kumanta ka na. Sayang, anak. Capital letters.
Okay.
And he passed a month later, June 30th.
Okay.
So I said, I will never sing again. Because he's the only one who wants to hear me sing. My mother likes my voice, pero my dad loves to hear my voice all the time.
Okay.
So, when TNT asked me, they said, can you sing? I was like, yeah. Paano? Paano ko kakanta without crying? Because you can talk to me about my love life nonstop. I will not shed a tear because I've forgiven everyone. But when it comes to singing, it comes with
two stories of feeling. No, it's two stories of death.
Yeah.
Of people who believed in your music. So I understand that.
Yes, but.
So, take me to the stage of Tawag ng Tanghalan. Having these stories sa loob ng iyong puso, how did it go? Paano mo kinaya?
Isa lang yung dasal ko dito, boy. I just said to myself, I wanna sing and finish the song without shedding a tear.
Kinaya mo?
By the grace of God, nothing else. I wasn't even thinking about yung maabot ko ba o maayos ko ba makanta. Hindi na yun. Sabi ko lang sa sarili ko, maawit ko na hindi ako lumuluha. Because I miss Him every day of my life.
Papa.
Tatay.
Tatay.
Tatay ko. I miss Him every day. And I look at my mother every day. And I just see yung nanay ko namimiss niya ang true love niya. Araw-araw.
Pero Rox, you also know that we have the power to change our perspective.
Yes.
Do you also realize that you have the power to change your mindset? Na kung dati takot dahil titabelya, na sobrang naniwala sa iyong kakayahang kumanta. Ang papa, ang tatay, na sobrang bilib na bilib at mahal na mahal ang kanyang anak dahil sa kanyang mga awitin. Ay pwede mo ring, you can turn that around and say, every note and every song I'm going to do, I'm going to pay tribute to my dad, to my tatay, and to my tita Belia, who believed in my music, in my talent, in my singing talent. Di ba? Pwede mong, you can turn that around and use that as a motivation.
Thank you, Tito Boy.
You can, right?
I will.
You will?
I will.
Uh-oh.
I have to figure it out.
You know, I'm sorry. You know why?
Yes, Tito
Because
Boy.
What a better way to pay tribute to people who believed in you. What can be a better way to say thank you for believing in my music?
I want to honor my dad and my mom.
And that's the best way to honor dad.
And my second mom.
That's the best way to honor mom, to honor Tita Belia, and remember the 18th treasure was that recording contract.
Yes.
And what a better way to honor dad every time he'd say, tugtugin mo nga, ilabas mo na anak ang kanta.
Thank you for the advice, Tito Boy. I will.
Yeah.
I promise you. That's what I'll do.
Promise yourself and promise dad.
I promise
Itabelia.
Myself.
Promise mom.
This is a moment I will cherish. Ah, wow.
Can I just share with you a story? You can edit this, guys. You know, many years ago, I did an interview of a young boy in Cagayan de Oro, Baguio. Madalas sila sumali ng contest, silang magkapatid, dalawa sila. This boy used to work for a fast food chain. Nagkabagyo, bumaha. Yung bahay nila, katabi ng dagat. So every time, masama ang panahon, halos naabot yung house nila, nasisira. That was one of the worst storms that hit the country. He was working, naalala niya yung bahay nila. He had to go home. Pinipigilan siya ng kanyang kapatid, dalawa sila kasi dahil masama na nga ang panahon, baka bumaha, baka hindi na siya makabalik. Nagpumilit siya. You know why?
Why?
I don't wanna cry. Because gusto niyang ma-retrieve yung rubber shoes niya na ginagamit tuwing sumasayaw sila sa mga contest. The short of the long story,
okay.
He passed away. He drowned in the sea. I cried in that interview because of the strength of the brother. Sabi niya sa akin, Tito Boy, ngayon, sasali pa rin ako sa mga contest. Pero, bawat sayaw, bawat kilos ng kamay, bawat step, gagawin ko para sa kapatid ko. That made a lot of difference. Sabi ko, bakit mo ginagawa ito? Sabi niya, kasi Tito, panalo na ako lagi. Because the biggest prize I can ever give my brother is to dance. It's the story of the rubber shoes. Now, I remember you because mahal na mahal ka ng dalawang taong ito, mahal na mahal ka ng mami mo. Do it for them. That's the price. Hard.
Ang hirap. Di ako nag-expect. Ano, titit?
Wow! Pero ang sarap, di ba, Rox? Sasampa ka dun sa TNT. May baong kwento, may baong bulong, may baong dasal. That, hey, I wanna do this for Tatay, I wanna do this for Tita Belia, I wanna do this for Mom. That makes you a winner.
Hi, oh my God. Tito Boy. Oh my God.
What song are you going to do?
Ano ba yan?
Wala pong pag-bounce back.
But that's good. It releases it, you know?
Ugoy ng duyan.
Oh my God.
Because? My strength is my nanay.
Your strength is your nanay.
Because dami na niya nadanasan, Tito Boy. Sobrang dami. Nagka-cancer na siya at 12 years old. Nagka-leukemia siya at the age of 13. Sinabi sa kanya ng doktor, in 3 months, you will die. Lahat, naundoy na rin kami, Tito Boy. Naghirap, nabugbog na siya ng tatay. Pang maalaala mo kaya ang buhay ng ina ko?
Oo.
Nagmahal, umalis, nabigo, nang parang ang storya ng buhay ng ina ko is unbelievable. So unbelievable.
You wanna pay tribute to your mom by doing the song?
I wanna remind her that she had a beautiful smile.
Are you going to do it with musica? Are you going to do it a cappella? How are you going to do it? I'm just so excited.
Oh, wow, Tito Boy. I'm singing it with the band of TNT.
With the band.
And they are really a blessing to me because they great. Carry yeah. Yeah. My voice.
Yeah.
If not for them, I can't even be on stage.
Am I allowed to at least hear a couple of lines from her? We cannot, no? Can you do another? But I love that song. It's a song composed by the great national artist, Maestro Lucio San Pedro, Ugoy ng Duyan. Kung hindi po ako nagkakamali, ang letra po nito ay ginawa ni Levi Celerio nung siya'y pauwi ng Pilipinas sa isang barko. I did a story on this song, Ugoy ng Duyan. Wow. Looking forward. Looking forward. Pero, Rox, if there is another song that you'd like to dedicate to your mom, to your dad, to Tita Belia, what song would this be?
Ang tatay ko sumulat ng isang awitin, which is entitled, Thank You Mama and Thank You Papa.
Mm.
I grew up, Tito Boy, na ang nanay at tatay ko laging nasa kwento, laging nasa araw-araw namin ang kwento ng lola at lolo ko. Mga lola at lolo.
Thank you, Mama. Thank you, Papa.
These are his lyrics to his parents.
A few lines, please.
You promised me that you would not leave me, and I believed you then. You've cared for me and loved me so dearly, and I have lived to be free. Today, as I see you both get older, your hair has turned to silver, but your smiles are more beautiful, your love more intense. Thank you, Mama, thank you, Papa, forever.
Napakahirap, tapos ang tawag sa'yo, Contra Diva.
I think diba? It's ano, Tito Boy, I like
I
being a...
I appreciate you, Rox. Really. I totally appreciate you. This message is very strong. Pagmamahal sa magulang, pagmamahal sa iyong mga lolo at lola, tatay, nanay, thank you.
You are the epitome of loving one's mother.
Thank you.
You have given her your all. Thank you
salamat.
Also. I appreciate you.
Maraming salamat. And all the best. Sabi ko nga, because I'm judging on your moment, ang pinakabagong talent search po dito sa ABS-CBN, walang flats at walang sharps, walang maling steps, pag ang ginagawa mo sa entablado ay galing sa puso. At pag ang dahilan ng ginagawa mo sa entablado ay pagmamahal. We will be right back. Kaiyak. We're back on the show with Roxanne Barcelo. Okay. Relax. Pag-usapan natin ng yung pelikula, Love to Love. What is this?
Okay. Love is Love is directed by GB.
It's Love is Love.
Yes, Love. No,
you're very polite. She could have corrected me. Akala ko Love to Love. What's Love to Love? It was an...
A show on...
You know why I know? Because it was...
Before.
Remember?
Before. Okay. Sunday habit.
Okay, all right. Sige. So, Love...
Love is...
Is love.
Okay. Yeah. Love is directed by Direk G.B. San Pedro, who was actually the first director who did a workshop for me and like a bunch of artists when I was 14 years old.
Talaga?
Yeah.
GB did some series dito sa ABS-CBN and he directed the first movie I produced, Astig, for Cinemalaya.
Wow.
Hindi lang ako sigurado if it was the first movie of GB, but kung hindi ako nagkakamali, it was the first. And I think he won as best director.
Galing. I was so thrilled when he messaged me okay. And when he sent me the script.
Did you ask him why he had you
Direk,
in mind?
Sabi ko, Direk, bakit ako?
Uh-huh.
Ang dami-daming artista dyan. Sabi niya, nung nabasa ko yung script, ikaw ang unang naisip ko.
Mm.
Ikaw talaga. Sabi ko, bakit Direk? Sinabi niya yung one-liner. Pero, pag sinabi ko yung one-liner na sinabi niya, I will give away the premise.
Okay, I understand. Kaya dapat panoorin ho natin ang pelikula. Love is Love. And then?
Love is Love.
Okay.
So, the story is about what love can truly do to one person. The things na hindi natin pinag-uusapan, na sabi nga ni Miss Beyonce, you can be crazy in love. Aminin na natin, ang love talaga parang can take you to different polarized emotions.
Of course.
So, pinuntahan ko yon para sa pelikula.
Ganda.
Pinuntahan ko muli.
Pinuntahan mo muli yung karanasan na yon.
Yes.
Para sa pelikula. Sino mga kasama mo dito?
Ang napaka-guwapo and very talented na si JC De Vera. Ang husay-husay
no,
niya.
No, very nice guy.
Oo. He shows me the picture of his wife and child all the time and I'm just so happy to see his happy family. So, to work with someone na... It's the first time I worked with JC.
Okay.
Masarap siya katrabaho. Magaan, wala siyang reklamo, and he was taping in between for General's Daughter, the General's Daughter. So, ano talaga, masipag at hinihimay namin bawat eksena.
Okay.
Bali, kaming tatlo ni Direk, GB San Pedro, and JC, we would really sit down kahit maubos yung oras.
Ba't nandiyan sila Peachy?
Yes, so si Peachy kasama.
Ah, is also
siya
with the film.
Ang best friend ko
okay.
Na nagbibigay sa akin ng advice about
and
love.
And si Marco?
Marco ang beshi naman
ni JC.
Ni Rufa.
Ah, ni Rufa?
Oo, so tatlo okay. Kaming magbe-beshi.
Wow!
Yes. Actually, the story does not revolve around the me and JC alone. It's a group of love stories.
Ah, okay, a community of friends.
Yes, a community of friends na nagmamahal at yung effect ng pagmamahal sa buhay ng isang tao.
Okay, you've done the movie. Now that you've done it, do you understand where, aside from the fact that GB gave you that line, now do you understand why you did the movie?
Yes, Tito Boy.
Okay, that's good.
Naintindihan ko. Pagkatapos ng pelikula, sabi ko, alam niya na, sabi niya din sa akin na, alam kong todo ka.
Meron kasi mga artista na pag nagagawa nilang pelikula, they'd say, I would have killed anybody who got this role because this belonged to me. Totoo yun. May mga ganun. After doing the film. And minsan, some actors don't understand at the beginning of the, at the onset of the film. Yes. But after doing the film, they'd say, oh, now I understand why I had to do the film.
I love it, Tito Boy. For the past 3 years,
that's good.
I have truly been blessed with the best roles ever. I cannot
Very
complain.
Good.
I changed my mindset. Kaya I will fully accept the advice that you gave me earlier. I think it's a change of mindset.
Yeah, because you have that power. We have that power.
Tinanggal ko po yung fear sa buhay ko.
Tama.
Tinanggal ko yung doubts sa buhay ko. Inisip ko na lang po at one point, sabi ko, I have nothing to lose because I've lost a lot.
Yeah.
And I decided, from now on, I want to gain and I love my job. I love everything I do and everything that is given to me is truly a blessing.
Ganda. That's cognitive restructuring. You can edit this, but I just wanted to give you an... you can edit this story.
I will not edit it in my head.
Do you know that Evita was one of the most coveted roles of Meryl Streep?
Wow.
Do you know that she didn't get it?
She would have loved it.
No, she wanted it so badly.
Oh my gosh.
She made people... She let people know that she wanted to do it so badly, but she couldn't get it for some reason. It went to Madonna.
Yes.
Okay, you know what she said after watching the movie? I wanted to slit her throat because any time of the day I can sing better. Hanggang ngayon.
Oh my gosh!
She cannot get over the fact that she didn't do Evita. So kahit, I mean, you know, great actors like Meryl Streep, pero din silang, that's why I ask, did you feel good after doing the movie? Because if you did, that was yours.
It took me to places that I've only dreamed of
Ganda.
Going.
As an actor.
As an actor.
Very good.
Because it's so much pain. So much pain. Over and over again.
Wow.
But the smile on her face was there throughout the whole
movie. The name of your character is?
Winona.
Winona.
Do you know Na? Winona.
I know Na. Tanungin mo ko ulit. Maganda yun, ha?
Do you know Na?
Winona and I know Na. Kailan mapapanood?
Malapit na.
Nang sambayanan.
December 5, mapapanood na in cinemas nationwide. Love
supportahan natin si Winona.
And Direct GB.
And GB San Pedro.
Yes.
And Peachy. And JC. And Marco. At lahat ng involved po sa pelikulang Love is Love.
Raymond Bagaching.
Wow.
Jay Manalo.
Wow. Napakahuhusay ng mga artista.
Nakakatuwa.
Congratulations. So that's December 5 is the day. Okay? We have a little game. It's called Yes, No, Maybe.
Oh.
That's all you have to say.
I love the maybes.
You
love? I love the maybes.
Bakit gusto mong maybes?
Masarap ang maybe.
May placard ka dyan.
Oh,
yes,
wow.
No, or maybe.
Oh, for the placard.
Ipapakita lamang sa amin kung yes, no, maybe.
I love, possibilities, Tito Boy.
You love possibilities.
I love possibilities.
I said this on TWBA. Again, dahil binabasa ko po yung libro ni Meryl Streep. Acting is pretending because acting and pretending are about imagined possibilities.
Yes. I love imagining. I love women and men and everything in between who love possibilities.
Okay. Yes, no, maybe. Takot ka ba sa gagamba?
Truly, madly, deeply, yes.
Ayan, meron!
Tito Boy. Nasa stun ako.
Talaga?
Nasa stun ako.
Paano nga? As in, catatonic?
Stun,
as in, talagang hindi ka makareact?
Tito Boy, when I was in high school, akala ko, nasa loob ng sapatos ko yung gagamba.
Oh my God.
Pagtanggal ko ng sapatos ko, tinaktak ko. Kasi meron akong quarterly exam, Tito Boy. Galing akong taping, alas 4 na po kami natapos. Bangag na bangag pa ako. Ganyan sabi ko, pagtaktak, walang bumagsak. Naramdaman ko muli. Inside the sock. Pag ganun ko, may gagamba. Yung sa bahay na malalaki.
Okay.
Nayupi ko.
Uh-oh.
Yung hiyaw ko, pang ano... pang aso na.
Oh.
Nandun na aso na levels.
Paano
na baliw
aso?
Na aso. Ano na
talaga, Tito Boy.
Iba na, hindi na pang tao, pang hayop na. Narinig na sa buong School of the Holy Spirit. Nagalit ang mga madre.
Gusto ko naman yun. Paano nga uli?
So, Deadman as a Spider-Man at Gagam Boy. Gagam Girl na lang.
Paano yung tunog?
Tahol. Tahula.
Okay. Yes, no, maybe. Totoo bang may nakasalubong kang katrabaho at inakala mong kaibigan na very cold ang naging response sa bongga mong pagbati sa kanya?
Tito Boy, kasi I'm super OA.
Totoo. At saka
OA kasi
very,
talaga ako.
You're very gregarious.
Ano talaga ako? Talagang pag may nakita akong friendship, ang taas. Walang middle ground sa akin.
Uh-oh.
Ay! Eme! Chari!
Magsabi ka nga ng totoo.
Baka kasi iba yung location. Eme!
Sandali. Okay, so maybe.
Maybe.
So, paano ka pag nakakakita ano ka kasi, as in talagang...
Pag nakatrabaho ko na kasi, Tito Boy, tapos syempre nag-a-acting kayo, right. Bigay todo, tapos, uh-huh. Ay, pak! Bakla! I miss you! Ganon.
Uh-huh.
Kakawayan ka.
And
Layas.
Oh.
Pero I mean, she's a friend forever in my heart. But minsan kasi, I understand that people have a long day. Minsan, hindi matapatan ang high
tama
intensity,
uh-uh.
Energy pero to Gary V.
pero after that,
from now on, I learned my lesson. Keep it at a 2. Let's keep it at a 2 or a 1.5. And from there, I will mirror
correct.
Your reaction. And I will build up from there.
Tama yun. So from pataas ng pataas.
Pataas na lang.
Or pa-exit. Pag
or pa-exit. Pag umi-exit, exit
pag
ka din.
Pag bumanon lang.
Hi. Kasi Tito, I mean, we've been in the industry
yes.
for a long time. But I don't really consider myself a showbiz.
Uh-huh.
If whatever that means, no. whatever, yeah, whatever that means.
Let me correct you. You're showbiz, and it's good to be showbiz. You are. I am.
Yeah. We are.
I am. Proudly showbiz.
Parang
showbiz
pagkaibigan ko na,
yeah.
yun na yun. Whether
yes.
magkita tayo after 10
and don't
years,
change,
15,
because that's you.
I go,
di ba? Halimbawa, pag ang sagot ay, oh, di, ganun pa rin. Okay.
I'll give it back.
Back. All right.
Back
yes,
to you.
No, maybe. Best friends pa ba kayo ni Marian Rivera?
Yes. Invited pa rin ako sa mga pagtitipon and tinetext pa rin niya ako.
Can I say that?
Yes.
Best friends pa rin ba kayo ni Marian? That's the way to pronounce it, Marian Rivera. Tama? Can I say that again? Because I want to pronounce it. I like the girl.
She,
best friends pa ba kayo ni Marian Rivera?
Pero syempre, Tito Boy, she lives a different life
na.
And I love her children. They're the most beautiful and... Zia is my inaanak.
Uh-huh.
And forever na yun, ninang na ako for life.
Yes. So the answer is yes.
A blue yes.
I think she's one of the most beautiful girls.
Yes.
Okay. Narito yung isang katanungan mula kay Cami Flores, 2425 via IG. Yes, no, maybe. Magiging host na ba sa ng It's Showtime si Roxanne Barcelo? Kaaliw siya.
Aww. Yan ang mga pampakilig ko. Yung
yeah.
mga, may pag-ganon. Parang dapat ko to ibigay sa ibang tao, hindi sa akin ang sagot.
Nagparamdam na, hindi pa.
Ano,
because people are talking about it. Ang daming naaaliw sa'yo and people are hoping and wishing.
Siguro, Tito Boy, dapat sa YouTube or sa mga platforms ng social media, pag sinabi nila yun, dapat may tanong, sure ka ba? Gusto niyo ba talaga ako makita everyday? Kasi, Tito Boy, medyo baliw talaga ako eh.
Oh, hindi medyo.
If I were given the chance,
yes.
it would be like a crown to me.
That's true. Okay. Very good. Yes, no, maybe. Have you or will you ever use sex to get what you want? What kind of a question is that?
My gosh, what a question.
Yeah, yeah. I know.
I've only used pure talent and hardships to
yeah.
get to where I am. And it's taking me the longest route.
That's true.
I would never.
But you will get there.
Thank you.
You will get
Unless it's the man I want.
Ta-da! Of course. Okay. And who is this man that you want now?
Tito Boy, wala.
Wala?
Pa.
You're not dating?
Ano, sabi ko kasi, actually, si John Lloyd Cruz ang nagsabi.
Okay.
3-month rule. Kamamatay lang ni Fadir.
Oo nga.
Pahinga muna. Eh, nagbilang ako. June, July, August, September. Pak! October na!
Ano ka? November na.
Ay, November na!
Okay. Okay.
Pero wala pa, Tito Boy. Okay. I'm still...
No, it's okay.
Kulikam.
Okay. Next. Si Will Devon ba ang nakipaghiwalay sa iyo noon? Yes, no, maybe.
Parang it's a tie.
It was a mutual decision.
It's a tie, Tito Boy. Kasi parang... Give me reasons and I'll give it. Chere.
Okay.
But, you know, we're best friends pa rin.
It's good.
And it's... I love his season now, Tito Boy.
Okay.
He's going to become... A daddy.
A dad?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
And,
okay.
Yeah.
You also know the girl? Friends?
I haven't met her, and okay. I'm only 5'3.5". I choose not to be the bigger person.
Okay. All right. I understand.
I will stay my height.
Stay there.
I'll stay here.
It's a nice place.
Yeah, I love okay? it.
Okay. Here, here's a series of questions. Yes, no, maybe. Nadala ba kayo ni McCoy De Leon sa kissing scene sa pelikulang G?
Wow. For the patakam, gusto niyo ba ng paganto? ano, Tito Boy? No, because okay. I will stay professional.
And you are.
I'm professional.
Next question. Naramdaman mo bang na-excite si McCoy while filming that scene?
Hindi po ako planchadora.
No. Kung hindi ka planchadora.
Labandera lang po
labandera
ako.
Labandera ka. Okay.
Naglalaba lang
McCoy
po.
McCoy asks you out on a date. Papayag ka ba? Yes, no, maybe.
Let's cross the bridge when we get there.
Wala yan dun eh.
Oo nga.
Pero maybe. Oo, maybe.
I'm not biased, Tito Boy.
Okay. Do you think you deserve better opportunities in showbiz? Underrated ka ba? Yes, no, maybe.
Basta rated.
Okay.
Whether it's on, pag under, okay na yun. Okay na yun. I mean, the opinions of others.
You're still in the radar.
I just love my job so much. And I'm not a multi-millionaire because of it, but I'm able to give to my family, I'm able to provide for myself, and I'm able to make others happy with what I truly love to do. It's just a blessing that I figured it out at the age of 13.
Okay.
And it's another blessing that my parents supported me all the way.
You make other people happy while you are happy. That's what you're doing.
Yes. That's if I am blessed
yeah.
to continue this path for the rest of my life, then hashtag blessed.
Blessed. Okay. Imbitahan mo muli ang sambayanan sa TNT, sa Love is Love, at sa lahat na ng iyong ginagawa.
Thank you, Tito Boy. Inaanyayahan ko po ang lahat na mag-phone in. Charot. Inaanyayahan ko po ang lahat to please watch Love is Love, directed by Direct GB San Pedro. GB San Pedro is one of the best directors that I've ever worked with, and it's such a blessing. Thank you, JC De Vera, for giving me an opportunity to work with you on this film. Abangan nyo rin po sina Raymond Bagaching, Miss Peachy, Rufa May Quinto, Jay Manalo, dito sa pelikulang ito. Abangan nyo rin po ako. Hopefully, hindi ko kasi alam kung
yeah.
by that time. Pero maraming salamat sa lahat ng mga sumusuporta sa akin sa tawag ng tanghalan, Celebrity Championship. Tuwang-tuwa po ako at binigyan nyo po ako ng susi muli sa pag-unlock sa aking boses. Thank you, and I will forever be grateful to you. Ah, thank you. Abangan nyo rin po, Manalo Matalo, ang aking album. Dahil pangako ko po sa aking ama na i-release ko ang aking tatlong kanta. Magsisimula po ito sa awiting Begin. When I was a kid, I used to believe in fairy tale endings, although you were lying to me. So tell me, how do I begin? Yun po.
Oo.
Thank you.
Ganda.
Salamat. Abangan nyo rin po ang aking pagiging kontra diva sa soap opera ni Miss Bea Alonso, ang kanyang pagbabalik. Thank you.
Tama ka na. Hashtag blessed.
Hashtag blessed. At isa pa po, I'm so excited to be a part of KZ Tandingan's film, Art of Ligaw. Sinulat at dinirect po ito ni Direk Jordan Sebastian. Palabas na po today, tonight, okay. November 5.
Wow.
Yes, thank
congratulations,
you.
Roxanne.
Thank you, thank
happy
you.
Happy for you. And Red Shoes and the Seven Dwarfs showing on November 13. Tangkilikin po natin lahat yan. And sa ano ba, sa Celebrity Champions sa TNT, sino yung ayaw mong makasabay?
Lahat.
Okay.
Lahat okay eh.
Wala kang iniilaga na baka pag nakasabay mo, eh medyo may tulog ako dito. Wala.
I love going to ABS-CBN na masaya.
Ganda. That's the spirit. Maraming salamat, Rox.
Yes.
I will see you soon.
And
keep on winning.
Wow, Tito
Boy. Yes, keep on winning. Boys of La Carmela de Boracay, thank you, Noel Arandilia of Manila Bankers Life, Move On, Mario Therese Clothing, True Money, Drs. Money and Pai Kalayan. At mga kapamilya, your moment starts November 9, this coming weekend. And November 9 and 10, ito po yung 2-in-1 talent competition ng ABS-CBN hosted by Luis and Vong. Ang judges po ay Billy, Nadine, and yours truly. That's your moment. Panoorin niyo po yan. Live and love in abundance and always make your nanay proud. Be kind. Abundance. Good night.
Tonight with